Good morning. My name is Liz Krueger. I'm the chair of the Senate Finance Committee, joined by Tom O'Mara, the ranker for the committee, and other members of the committee. We're doing our meetings virtually because, unfortunately, COVID continues to attack the legislature, as well as everyone else in the state of New York. Today's committee meeting will not cover bills, and it will only cover nominations. We have one person appearing because he is a nominee to become the commissioner of the Civil Service Commission, a paid position. And then we have an extensive list of people who will not be appearing because they have been nominated by the governor to serve in non-paid jobs on behalf of the state of New York. But first, we're going to interview Mr. Timothy Hoges, recommended to us by the governor to be the commissioner of the Civil Service Commission. And Mr. Hoges, we will ask you to give us a brief sort of opening statement about why you believe you are qualified to take on this job for the state of New York.
Thank you. Good morning, Senator Krueger and members of the Finance Committee. My name is Timothy Hoges, and I want to thank you for the opportunity to join you today. It is an honor to have been nominated by Governor Hochul to serve as New York's next commissioner and president of the Civil Service Commission. I want to speak to you about three things this morning. First, I'll share a little bit about myself. Next, I will talk about the unique combination of passion and skills I will bring to this job. And finally, I would like to close by talking about my commitment to racial equity and why that matters as the next civil service commissioner. I am a native New Yorker, born and raised in Western New York. I have a BA in Business Administration and Management from the University at Buffalo. I am a husband, father of three, and minister at the Elam Christian Fellowship Church. Three jobs from which I take great joy and to which I dedicate great love. Before entering public service, I spent over 15 years in the private sector, working as an operations manager for several private firms in the Western New York area. It was in these roles that I honed my skills for managing people and the systems they work in. And it was these same skills that I made an integral contribution to Erie County's COVID response efforts. In my capacity as personnel commissioner, I worked closely with the county health commissioner to ensure our personnel and operational systems kept pace with the spread of the virus throughout the Erie County. To do this, I helped the health department create staffing charts based on both the number of calls and times of day people called into our COVID hotline. I also used infection rates by zip code to help establish and staff pop-up testing locations in the community, along with vaccine clinics when the vaccine became available. In 2012, my career took a new turn and I entered into public service. First as an elected official in the Erie County Legislature, then as Commissioner of Senior Services, and finally as the Commissioner of Personnel. As a legislator, I chaired the Finance and Management Committee, as well as the Public Safety Committee. As a Senior Services Commissioner, I helped improve the overall congregate dining experience and expand non-traditional dining options for thousands of older adults throughout Erie County. Finally, as Erie County's Personnel Commissioner, I oversee services provided to over 130 appointing authorities and approximately 24,000 employees countywide. I strongly feel that people should work at the intersection of their passion and talents. I believe that doing so not only makes a person happy and fulfilled, but it also makes their community a better place. I have a passion for faith, family, service, and building a more just community. And I have a talent for leading people and managing operations and systems. All my life, I've had the great fortune of being able to marry my passion for service and justice with my talent for engaging people to achieve great things. And the job for which I am presently nominated is no different. In my capacity as the next commissioner and president of the Civil Service Commission, I am confident that my skills as a gifted operationalist and manager can also be married with my commitment to service and building a stronger, better New York, more grounded in justice, fairness, and equity. Operationally, I'm confident I can navigate staffing support to New York's approximately 70 agencies with roughly 140,000 state employees. I'm likewise confident that with my talented colleagues in the Department of Civil Service and the elected leadership throughout the state, I can help ensure our employees are fulfilling our collective mission to serve the public. Finally, I would like to offer a brief reflection on racial equity. As you can imagine, after the tragic and horrific events of Saturday, May 14th, in my hometown of Buffalo, New York, this issue was already top of mind. Is now something I am hyper-focused on. I represent the county executive on the Greater Buffalo Racial Equity Roundtable. And in that capacity, I work with the administration to ensure racial equity training was offered to all county employees. And I've also worked hard to ensure racial equity training will be a part of the onboarding process for new employees. I raise this because I believe racial equity to be a core tenet in my belief system. And I know it is a priority shared by Governor Hochul. Without it, the promise of shared opportunity provided by New York State is hollow. This belief system is relevant to the title of Civil Service Commissioner for two reasons. First, because it underscores the values and principles on which the work of the state workforce must stand. And second, because it ensures that New York State has the most talented workforce. When we do not make racial equity together with diversity and inclusion a part of our workforce culture, we miss talent, we miss the opportunity to recruit the best and brightest young people New York State has to offer. We miss the talent that may be trapped in poverty, exclusion, and bigotry. As your next Commissioner of Civil Service, I promise to do all I can to not allow New York State to miss the opportunity to bring in the best talent. Please allow me to close with one of my favorite quotes. In December of 1961, Martin Luther King Jr. said, "The two most dynamic and cohesive liberal forces in the country are the labor movement and the Negro freedom movement. Together, we can be the architects of democracy." Senators, at a time when our democracy is challenged by the toxic combination of gross inequality and white supremacy, please allow me the opportunity to marry my talents and passion yet again. Please allow me to help build New York State's labor workforce such that it is the most talented, diverse workforce in the country, and simultaneously on the front lines of racial equity, service, and democracy. Again, I would like to thank Governor Hochul for the nomination, Senator Krueger and this committee for your consideration. But most of all, I would like to thank my mother and father for all they have instilled in me and all the sacrifices they have made to allow me to be who I am today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hoges. And anybody who would like to ask questions of Mr. Hoges, please raise your hand. I see Tim Kennedy's hand up.
Yeah, thank you, Chairwoman Krueger. First of all, Commissioner, congratulations on this nomination. I want to recognize and congratulate Governor Hochul on putting forward such an honorable man of integrity and passion and service an experience, somebody that meets all of the criteria that our state would want and we need in this moment and for the future of the great state of New York. I think what Commissioner Tim Hoeges brings with him is a set of skills unlike anyone else that we could possibly name. I certainly recognize him as one of the best leaders in all of New York State and someone that should absolutely be elevated. Whatever I can say about Commissioner Tim Hoeges, having known him for well over a decade, not just his work in government as an elected leader, as an appointed leader, as a commissioner of the Department of Senior Services in Erie County, as a commissioner of the Department of Personnel in Erie County, as an active member of his church in the community, as a volunteer in the community on so many different organizations that help move our Western New York community forward and hence our state. Nothing could possibly say it better than what he just said. I think what Commissioner Hoeges just articulated in his own words is exactly the reason why this committee should see that we move this to the floor for a vote as expeditiously as possible. And Madam Chair, I'm happy to do just that and move this nomination. Thank you. And again, Commissioner Hoeges, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Kennedy. Senator Gallivan, your hand is up.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I too will be supporting this nomination. I want to first congratulate Commissioner Hoeges on the nomination and thank him for his willingness to accept it. Like Senator Kennedy, I travel, and others, of course, we travel many hours to get to Albany and then get back to our district. And so we know what that entails. And thank you, Commissioner Hoeges, for being willing to take that on. I also thank you for your service to the citizens of Erie County in Western New York. In my view, Commissioner Hoeges has been an outstanding public servant and an outstanding member of the community. And he's been willing to stand up time and again, both in a paid capacity and probably more importantly, in a capacity as a citizen and a volunteer, being involved in many community organizations and helping out the community. So I will be supporting the nomination. Commissioner, I thank you for your service. I look forward to working with you in the new capacity and congratulate you.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you, Senator Gallivan. Does anyone else wish to ask questions or speak on Mr. Hoeges? Well, then I'll just say that I had an opportunity. Oh, Senator Liu. No? Okay. I will call on you in a minute. So I just want to say that I also had an opportunity to interview Mr. Hoeges, and I was extraordinarily impressed with his background, his experience, and his ideas of how he would help the state move forward in this continually challenging environment of needing to make sure we have people who actually want to come to work for the state of New York and who can be supported to develop the skills that we may need them to modernize as they're moving forward in their careers with us, and to expand the opportunities for a more diverse universe of New Yorkers to participate in becoming civil service workers for the state. So I also want to congratulate Governor Hochul for, I think, providing us with an extraordinarily qualified candidate with a great deal of background and experience in this field. John Liu, did you wish to motion? Okay, I'm gonna let John Liu motion.
I'll second.
Senator Borrello seconds.
I provided that motion, but I will defer my friend from downstate.
Excuse me, excuse me.
I gotta be there for my Buffalo.
Wait, I support Tim Kennedy as being the for that role also.
Fine.
Is a bipartisan
John Liu and Tim Kennedy supported by George Borrello in the support for Mr. Hoeges moving forward to the floor for confirmation. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without recommendation? Mr. Hoges moves to the floor at some point in the future. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I look forward to working with all of you.
Thank you. Okay, now we have a fairly long list of nominees. Again, unpaid positions. Some of them are re-ups, meaning they are already in this position, but their time frame was over, so they need to be renominated. Some are new. These are not employees per se. Some of the positions actually do have per diems attached to them for meetings, but none are defined as requiring an interview with the finance committee. They've all gone through the relevant committee of issues before they got to finance. So Tom O'Mara and I have agreed that we can just read all of them off at one time. And then you can, as you choose, be selective about any people you wish to vote no or yes on. And you can do that either verbally when we get through the entire list, or by checking off yes or no on your voting sheet. So I'm now going to ask Aaron if he could read us the entire list of nominees.
We have John Ernst, board member of the Adirondack Park Agency. Denise Donnell, Major General, Air National Guard Department of Military and Naval Affairs. John Aldrich, member of the Board of Historic Preservation. We have Dewey Wayne Goodman, member of Board of Historic Preservation. Daniel Lynch, member of the Albany Legislature, Capital District Transportation Authority. Francis Saya III, member of the Labor Representative, Central New York Regional Transportation Authority. Amy Schmidt, member of the Council on Human Blood and Transfusion Services. David Husky, also a member. Timothy Hilbert, also a member of the Council of Human Blood and Transfusion Services. And Jessica Jacobson, also a member. Nathan Coogan, a board member of Janice State Park. Lauren Penman, also a board member. Laura Rowe, Board of Visitors, Home of Veterans and Their Dependents at Oxford. Harold Poor, the third member, Orange County Metropolitan Transportation Authority. David S. Sack, member, Nassau County Metropolitan Transportation Authority. Frank Borelli, member, Rockland County Metropolitan Transportation Authority. Susan P. Heil, member, Board of Visitors, the New York State Home of Veterans and Their Dependents at Montrose. Sophie Liberatore, member of the Board of Visitors, New York State Home and Veterans for the Dependents at Oxford. Samika Sullivan, member, Niagara Frontier State Park Recreation and Historic Preservation Commission. Michael Hughes, member and chair of the Niagara Frontier Transportation Authority. Joseph Martins, member and chair of the Olympic Regional Development Authority. David Mortimer, board member of Palisades Interstate Park. Bryce O'Brien II, member of Palisades Interstate Park Commission. Diane Zeller, member of the Port of Oswego County. Lori Altramari, member of the Rochester-Janice Regional Transportation Authority. Faye Christian, board member of the Roosevelt Island Operating Cooperation. Eleanor Mullaney, board member of the Saratoga Capital District State Park Recreation and Historic Preservation Commission. Heather Mabee, also a member. Raul Aguirre, also a member. Edgar Masters, a member of the Taconic State Park Recreation and Historic Preservation Commission. Linda B. Tarrant Reed, also a member. And Michael Travowski, board member of the Thousand Island State Park.
Okay, thank you very much. Are there any questions anyone has about any of the nominees, or any statements anyone wishes to make about any of them?
Madam Chair, just quickly.
Yes,
Madam Chair.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just going to make a comment on Michael Hughes. He is a fellow Western New Yorker. I've known him for a while. He's done great things in the community, and I'm glad to see him nominated and be supporting him.
Thank you. And Senator Kennedy, did I see your hand up also?
I have my hand up here. Thank you. A couple of things. First of all, I'd like to recognize Mike Hughes as the new chair of the NFTA, as a chair of the Transportation Committee. I can recognize him as someone that has worked on that board for over a decade. And again, I want to recognize and congratulate Governor Hochul on putting such an extraordinary individual forward to serve as the chair of that board. And I would like to also just, if this is a possibility, move all of these names as a block in their entirety without objection, unless you'd like to do something different there, Madam Chair.
No, I was hoping to do that. I just wanted to give everybody a chance to speak up on anyone or raise any concerns. But I see no other hands up. So I'm going to accept Tim Kennedy's motion to accept all of the nominees as a block. Will somebody second that, please? Thank you, Senator Liu, for seconding. No, you're not seconding. Okay, you're not seconding. I'm sorry. Then Senator Borrello is seconding. All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec?
I'll be without rec on the entire list, please.
Okay, Senator O'Mara. And is there any individual no's or without recs that anyone wants to go on record with? Senator Liu? You're not, okay, there's no verbal here. But check off your
vote. Put it in the chat. You can write it in the chat.
Or you could just put it in your voting sheet. They will all be recorded. So we'll let it go that way. And with that, I believe that we do have the votes to move this entire list to the floor. And with that, I'm actually going to close down this Finance Committee meeting, but tell you that we might have one more virtual meeting later in the week to complete a few additional nominees that the governor got us later than could be dealt with today. It may be next week, but we might try to sneak one in for later in the week. It will not be bills. It would only be some additional nominees that came in late, three additional nominees for the MTA, actually, Senator Kennedy. They will need to go through the transportation and the authorities board. But in defense of the governor, these were recommendations of others who have appointees to the board, and the materials just didn't get to anyone in time, which is why we are struggling to make sure we try to get these people confirmed before the end of session, even though they came in a bit late. And I do want to thank Senator Kennedy and Senator Comrie, who of course held meetings relating to multiples of these people yesterday, and the Finance Committee members were invited to attend then. So appreciate your being so helpful and cooperative in getting all of this done. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
With that, I believe we can close today's committee meeting, and I will see everybody, I guess, on the floor or in Zoom form later on in the day. Thank you very much.
Thank you.